Greetings, saints. I greet you in the most powerful name of our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior. I've been set up by one of my prayer partners to talk about generational curses. And I'm not sure if I'm all, you know, clued up about this topic, but I do have a little bit of knowledge that I can share with all the intercessors in this group, and whereby each and every one of us can learn from, and whereby everyone is also welcome to add their comments, and let's talk about this, because most of the challenges that we are facing, we do not know where they all started. And the word of God says that sin brings death into our lives. There is only one thing that brings death, that brings troubles, that brings chaos into our lives. It is sin. And so all our troubles, all the generational curses that we might have been experiencing in our lives, they were brought by sin into our lives. And it could have been the sins that we performed or the sins that our forefathers performed. But because these sins have been running through the bloodline, because when our parents, or we as parents, we don't live in accordance to the plan and the will of God. We do not follow the precepts of God. We don't follow the statutes, the commandments. Automatically, we give a foothold to the kingdom of darkness. So the enemy is now able to come in and begins to devour our lives and begins to destroy our lives. So I'm going to be reading from the book. There is not in the Bible, you know, but I'm going to be contrasting this book with the book of Galatians 5, the book that I read from yesterday and today. And you are welcome to, if you want me to share this book with you, I will share it with you. However, there is some words that are missing in the book. I don't know why there's missing words there, but I know that when you read it, you will get the gist of the story, and it will help each and every one of us grow. So I'm going to be reading from verse 18 of this book, and I'm going to be skipping a lot of verses, because there's a whole lot more information that is too that is too advanced, if I may put it that way, and it won't be easy for me to go through it within this particular setup. It will take a very long time. It might even go to 2 hours, so I don't want to take a lot of time, because I don't want you to get tired while you're listening and then you end up sleeping. So I'm going to read from verse 18 of the book of Bartholomew. And then Bartholomew was afraid and fled and said unto Jesus, Lord, give me an hem of thy garments, that I may have courage to draw near unto him. Okay, maybe let me just go above a little bit, so that I can maybe give you a little bit of an idea of what was going on here. Lana, we find ama disciples that Jesus, after Jesus Christ had risen from the dead, the disciples were very curious. They would go to Jesus, they will ask him a lot of questions, and then Jesus Christ will answer them. And sometimes when he answered them, he would, you know, become graphic about it. He will make examples, live examples, you know, so that they see exactly what is going on, you know, in this world and in the world that is unseen. So here it's in verse 7. When Jesus appeared again, Bartholomew said unto him, Lord, show us the adversary of men. So what Bartholomew was asking here from Jesus, he was saying, show us the enemy of men. When he said, show us the adversary of men, that we may behold him. So they wanted to see the enemy of men. This is so brave of Bartholomew. Okay, and then it continues to say, of what fashion is he, and what is his work? You know, Bartholomew here was raising the very important questions, because we need to know our adversary. We need to know our enemy, that who is our enemy? What is he armed with? What is it that he does to us? Because when we do not know what the enemy does to us, then that this is where most of us lose everything, because now we begin to make very small mistakes, thinking that they're small mistakes, not knowing that they are huge, you know. So I'm continuing to read. And whence he comes from, and that power he has, what power he has, that he has spared not even thee. So now, Bartholomew, you know, this adversary had so much power that he didn't even spare Jesus Christ on the cross. He crucified him on the cross. And now, verse 8, but Jesus looked upon him and said, thou bold heart, thou askest for that which thou art not able to look upon. So what Jesus Christ is saying here, he's saying to Bartholomew, hey, you are so brave. Ugut, you're asking for something that you cannot even look at. So we're going to be skipping straight to to Vespa. Let me see. I want to skip a lot of, you know, verses here, because now this is going to take too long. Okay, let us just see what is happening in verse 10. And as he thus spake, Jesus raised him and said unto him, Bartholomew, wilt thou see the adversary of men? So, O Jesus Christ, do you really want to see the enemy of men? I tell thee that when thou beholdest him, not thou only, but the rest of you, you will not be able to stand it. Like I said, Dugiti, there are words that are missing here, but then you will be able to see what is going on. I'm sorry about that. And then Jesus Christ here opened the he asked Michael to open the underworld, and then Michael did that. Michael the angel, we all know the Michael the angel, and then came out Obeliah. And Obeliah is this, you know, angel of darkness, and this angel of darkness is so huge that the measurements Zayu, they've been mentioned here, but like I said, that it's going to take a very long time to explain all those things and to even talk about them. So I'm gonna skip straight to verse 14. And straightway when the apostles saw him, they found fell to the earth on their face and became as dead. So when my apostles saw this Belial, they were so afraid, they fainted, because now Jesus Christ told them, hey, Luna, you are so brave, you want to see something that you cannot stand. So when Belial was brought out by the angel Michael for them to see, who is this adversary of men, they fell on their faces, you know, as if they were dead. So I guess they fainted. And then in verse 15, but Jesus came near and raised the apostles and gave them a spirit of power. And he said unto Bartholomew, come near, Bartholomew, and trample with thy feet on his neck, and he will tell thee his work, what it is, and how he deceives men. Because it is very important for you to know that how the devil deceives you. Because he has got his ways of deceiving men. So, Bartholomew here and the apostles, they ask a very relevant question, of which is the question that most of the Christians should be asking today. And because maybe of our ignorance, we don't ask those questions. And then I'm moving to verse 16. And Jesus stood afar off with the rest of the apostles, and Bartholomew feared and raised his voice and said, blessed be the name of thine immortal kingdom from henceforth even forever. And when he had spoken, Jesus permitted him, saying, go and tread upon the neck of Belial. And Bartholomew ran quickly upon him and trod upon his neck, and Belial trembled, you know. So, Bartholomew was given a permission by Jesus Christ to go to him and trample over him. And then he did that, as scary as he was, because this was a huge demon in accordance to the measurements that have been given above. And Bartholomew was afraid and fled and said unto Jesus, Lord, give me an hem of thy garment, that I may have courage to draw near unto him. So Bartholomew realized, no, even though I could put my feet on his neck and he trembled, that demon, but he was very afraid, because this thing was huge and this thing was ugly. When it is explained there, the description of it, it was very ugly. It's not a good thing that you should look at as a human being. So, and then when we go to verse 19, but Jesus said unto him, thou canst not take an hem of my garment, for these are not my garments which I wore before I was crucified. So it means which when Jesus Christ was crucified, he was wearing the garments as Zalaim Shabin, but when he was raised from the dead, the garments that he was wearing now, they were not the garments as Zalaim Shabin. So no one deserved to wear such garments here on earth except him. So we move to verse 22. And as Bartholomew drew near, fire was kindled on every side. So Jesus Christ told him to go back to Belial, but then what Jesus Christ did, he kindled him with fire all around him, so that his garments appeared as fire. Now, Jesus said to Bartholomew, as I said unto thee, tread upon his neck and ask him that what is his power. And Bartholomew here was given power by Jesus Christ. I'm surrounding a fire. Like, impahla bekazigqokile, they were like umlilo. So that abenamandla, it means with nati ezabazalwane, we need the fire of God within us and all around us. And that fire, you can only generate it by repenting from your sins and from every unrighteousness that we have ever been, so that we can be able to generate this power in us. for all of us to be able to stand against all the works of the enemy, all the works of our adversary. And then I'm continuing to read. As I said unto thee, tread upon his neck and ask him what is his power. And Bartholomew went and trod upon his neck and pressed down his face into the earth as far as his ears. So, you know, now Bartholomew had so much power that he pressed him down, even with his ears, he pressed him down. And Bartholomew said unto him, tell me who thou art, and what is thy name? And he said unto him, lighten me a little, and I will tell thee who I am, and how I came hither, and what my work is, and what my power is. So Lana, this demon, was so oppressed by Bartholomew that he wasn't able to speak properly. So he asked Bartholomew, would you know, loosen your foot a little bit so that I can be able to speak. I will tell you everything. I will tell you who I am and what my power is. And he lightened him and said to him, say all that thou have done and all that thou doest. So Bartholomew wam lightena up mara, then what is strelege ukuti, what is it that you do and what is it that you have done? And Beliah answered, I'm continuing, I'm reading verse 25 now. And Beliah answered and said, if thou will know my name, at the first I was called Sataniel, which is interpreted a messenger of God. But when I rejected the image of God, my name was called Satanas, that is an angel that keeps hell. And Tartarus, in brackets, they've written Tartarus. And these Tartarus, I think we do find these Tartarus in the Bible somewhere. It's just that I didn't have enough time to prepare for this lesson for me to go into the Bible and see where this Tartarus is. But we do have it in the Bible. It could be in the book of Revelations, maybe. I'm not sure. And verse 26, and again Bartholomew said unto him, reveal unto me all things, and hide nothing from me. And verse 27, and he said unto him, I swear unto thee by the power of the glory of God, that even if I would hide aught, I cannot, for he is near that will convict me. For if I were able, I would have destroyed you like one of them that were before you. So what is Beliah is saying here, Uchela U Bartholomew and my disciples, which, you know, even if I wanted to hide izinto from you, I will not be able to hide izinto from you, because the one that will destroy me is near. The one that will convict me is near. And if it was according to my power, I would have destroyed you, Bartholomew, and your fellow apostles. Like I destroyed the ones that were before you. And then verse 28-29, ikuluma ngama angels, which is the order of angels, how were they created and all that. And that is gonna take too long. I can't read that. And then we run straight to verse 37. And then now we get to the gist of the story now. And verse 38. Obeliah lana ati, wilt thou that I declare unto thee the punishment of the hypocrites? Ne? Usekayamtshela ke lana ukuthi yini abayenzayo ebantwini. Ukhuluma ngokuthi they cause abantu baba ma hypocrites, baba ma backbiters, baba ma jesters, ama idolaters. Ama idolaters yilaba abantu abakhonza iThixo. And the covetous ilaba nje abahlale bahalela nje izinto zabantu and bazihalela ngendlela enomona kakathi. So yilento le uBhelaya akakhuluma ngayo lana. And the adulterers, ama-adulterers siyazi ukuthi yilabo ukuthi unendoda or unenkosikazi ubhizi uhamba afuna abanye abantu ngaphandle other than unkosikazi wakhe or other than the husband yakhe. And the wizard, ama-wizard yini abaloyi, the witches and the diviners, ama-diviners yilaba ba ama-fortune tellers or something like that. So uBhelaya la uyamchazela ukuthi yini abayenzayo, yini eyenza ukuthi umuntu abe far from God or abe derailed from ezindleleni zakaNkulunkulu. And if you look at what Bhelaya is saying here, this is what is in Galatians 5 that I read yesterday. That would be from verse 19, 20, and 21. If you can read Galatians 5, ngesiZulu abase Galatia, and verse 19, verse 20, and verse 21. If you can read there. So lana uBhelaya is telling uBartholomew ukuthi what is it that they do to people. And then verse 38 here continue to say, but they that do these things and they that consent unto them or follow them do perish with me. So lana we have an angel of hell of Tartarus that lives under the world. He is telling uBartholomew nama apostles wakhe ukuthi bonke laba bantu laba ama adulterers, ama wizards, ama witches, ama diviners, ama hypocrites, ama backbiters, ayilaba abakhoveta izinto zabo makhelwane babo, zonke lezo zinto lezi, those people they perish with uBhelaya, which is the angel of hell. Ne? And in verse 39:18, Bartholomew said unto him, declare quickly how thou persuadest men not to follow God and thine evil arts that are slippery and dark, and they should leave the straight and the shining paths of the Lord. Bartholomew said unto him, I will that thou declare in a few words. I'm looking at the time. And Bartholomew said, dost thou then do these things by thyself alone? And Satan said, if I were able to go forth by myself, I would have destroyed the whole world in 3 days. Did you hear that? This is how powerful this angel of darkness is. This is how powerful this angel of hell is. Ukuthi yena njengoba umhlaba umkhulu kangaka angawudestroya in 3 days. So Jesus Christ or uNkulunkulu akamphanga lawo mandla lawo ukuthi akwazi ukudestroya umhlaba. So asizwe ke ukuthi uthini, but neither I know any of the 600 go forth. So kule 600 angels akakhuluma ngazo, it's the 600 angels of hell. Ne? For we have other swift ministers whom we command. So banama ministers wabo, Satan nayo unama ministers wabo abawathumelelayo. And it continues to read and say, and we finish them with a hook of many points and send them forth to hunt. Ne? And they catch for us souls of men. And we all know that a man is comprising of a body, mind, soul, and the spirit. Angit. So lana, this angel of darkness says that, and they catch for us souls of men. Into important, emntwini ku Satan is your soul. Once he has that, then he's finished with you. Enticing them with sweetness of diverse baits, that is by drunkenness and laughter and backbiting and hypocrisy and pleasures and fornication. If you go to Galatians 5, as I have said, you go to from verse 19 up to verse 21, you will find these things there. So what are all these things have to do with the generational curses? We don't know our forefathers. There's generations and generations and generations that were before us whom we didn't know ukuthi how they lived. And what I've learned ukuthi mina as umzali mangabe ngikhuleka ngikhonza uNkulunkulu ngenza everything, automatically abantwana bami they are covered in the blood of Jesus, and the devil knows ukuthi these are my children, they are covered. Know that he will not try to tamper with them. He will try to tamper with them, but automatically there is a coverage of God upon my children. Same applies to the kingdom of darkness. When our forefathers, they worshipped those idols, they were drunkards, they were hypocrites, backbiting, fornication. And we must remember that tina black people, I culture yetu begu nama concubines, bekufika kube no wife, kube nama concubine, kube nama wives, abanye baya shadwa, begu nesithembu, begu nazo zonke lezo zinto, yonke lo hajest lay. So obviously these spirits, when tina sikhula now, they just, you know, take over us, because we are in the same bloodline. That is how the enemy is able now to disrupt our lives. And these things, they are carried from generation to generation. And sometimes there is no one that must even teach you how to be a drunkard, how to fornicate, how to do those things. Those spirits, they will come in, they will entice you to fornication, and you just feel your body changes. You don't even know what is happening with your body. You just feel like, you know, going to fornicate and all that. No, it is those spirits that are around you that are now trying to enter you through fornication, because I'm an evil spirit. They always seek the body to live in. So immediately when you start living outside the will of God, they now come in and they live in you. That is why now in our families we have people who are drunkards, we have people that are taking drugs, we have people that are murderers, we have people that are hypocrites, we have all sorts of people in our families. And these people in our families, they bring a trouble enye. And that is why in some families we find ukuthi kunabantu nje abazoguliswa yi-cancer. That is why even when you go to the doctor, will ask you nge history of family yakho ukuthi kukhona no sugar, kukhona no cancer, kukhona nesifuba, kukhona nani, because they know ukuthi these things, they go in the bloodline. And thina as abantwana bakaNkulunkulu ke now that have repented, because we also need to repent for the sins of our forefathers, because these things, they run in the bloodline. So we need to ask for forgiveness from God. Even those things that you don't know, because we wouldn't know what our forefathers did. No one will tell us. We don't know these forefathers, who they were and all that. But we are in the same family tree. We are in the same family bloodline. So we need to ask for forgiveness for all those sins. We need to repent for them. And now we need to start praying. Now, ukuthi bloodline yetu ne family tree yet, it has to be cleansed in accordance to the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ needs to now to be in the roots of that family tree, so that if family tree yet is renewed, kungabi nama drunkards in our families, kungabi nabantu abaloyayo in our families, kungabi nabantu abafornicatayo in our families. As much as umhlaba wonke is full of fornication, is full of sexual sexual immorality, but tina we can change the bloodline yet, the family tree yet, ukuthi starting with us, there shall be no fornication anymore in our families. Our family members, they shall have sexual intercourse in marriage when they get married. But that is not going to happen if mina, I'm sitting here, I'm praying, ukuthi there shall be no fornicators in my family anymore, while mina, I live in fornication myself. It is not going to change. Instead, things are going to get worse. Even worshipping idols, even visiting ama witch doctors. If I say no, abantu they shouldn't visit ama witch doctors, and I pray within my family they should stop this. But if me, not the person that is standing in the gap, I am not stopping those things, then what will happen? Ukuthi these evils will continue in our family. That is how our generational curses I don't know if I can use the word, ukuthi they are made or they are adopted in our families. So in order for our bloodline to be cleansed, tina, ama intercessors, as we stand in the gap, we need to pray for our families. We need to repent for our forefathers and for our parents and for our grandparents, whoever it is that is in our family, that we are asking for forgiveness. And we are asking, oh Jesus Christ, ukuthi he restructures now our family tree in accordance to the blood of Yeshua the Christ, and in accordance to the plan and the will of God, because there is a plan of God, like I said in my prayer, I think it was in this morning or yesterday, that there is a plan of God about our lives. But because we have been taught about the systems of this world, we don't know what the plan of God is. We follow on the plan of the system of this world, because the world has taught us we must go to school, we must go to varsity, after that we must go to work, we must go do that. But we know nothing about the will of God. What have you been called to do here on earth? So we need to pray, bazalwane, pray for these generational curses to break. And each and every one of us, I'm sure that we have observed in our homes, ukuthi, what is happening in our homes? What is a trend? In some families, you will find ukuthi trend yakhona, abantu bayakhona bayagula, baphathwa i-cancer, abantu bakhona ba drop out esikolweni, abaqhubeki nemfundo. Not that education is so important these days, but yeah, you will find that kune poverty kuma families amanye, kune into nje etrendayo in that family. So you will know ukuthi then that is the generational curse that is there. And in our families, guna these animals, I need to cut this audio now. Guna these animals that my families would have, you know, adopted. I remember in my family, when I was growing up, when we saw a green snake, maybe the green snake is just crawling in the yard, and we will run, we want to kill it. And my grandmother will say, no, don't kill that snake. That is your grandmother, or that's your grandfather, or whatever. They are visiting. And I'm sure most of the people here can witness that. So each and every family clan, you'll find that there is that animal that is representing the kingdom of darkness. So they will tell you that those are the ancestors, and those animals, they are evil. That is why you'll find that some families, they die mysteriously, or they live for a certain age, and then after a certain age they die. It is because of those covenants that were made by our forefathers, which now have brought these generational cases into our lives. I will break here. If there are any questions, I don't know if I'll be able to answer every one of them, but let's throw them onto the platform, and then we will discuss about them. Let us open a discussion about this. I thank you so much for listening. Thank you. Have a lovely evening.